Welcome back to Overtime, ladies and gentlemen. The top plays madness continues here for our last segment. We're gonna go back, take it back to the Brisk. The last Brisk, we've talked about him before here, but we've got the top five plays in the books, in the queue, ready to be played. You guys ready for this?
Am I? Oh boy, am I, Wave Punk.
Why are you looking at me?
Quinn's like, I don't know what happened
to
these people.
I'm so ready for this.
Number five.
Okay.
Number five was Nose Dude in the air, setting up his teammate Jacob. This is a pretty nuts play. You see, it's like, and Stat Junior's like, I got this.
What?
Nope, you don't exist anymore. You don't exist anymore. Jacob, gonna put that one through.
A demo, dude?
Yeah, when I was casting this, I couldn't tell if it was on purpose, but it's 100% on purpose when you watch it later.
Oh, that's
went
so sick.
Straight for the undercarriage.
It's hard to play defense when you just don't exist anymore. <you know?
laughs> The perspective from Sad Junior is so great. You just see Nose Dude flying in from the bottom.
I wonder what Sad Junior said.
All right, number four, Darkfire. He had quite the weekend here with some fantastic plays. We might actually see him again later on in the top five. But here at number four, the quick midfield redirect, upside down, why not? Oh. Two defenders there, can't get him.
It's just so pretty. It's just one of those things, I just want to watch it. You just want to watch it again.
Just watch.
One of those gifts that you've let repeat a billion times.
There's the beautiful contact in between his front wheels, too.
Yeah.
It's like exactly where it needed to be. Moving on, number three. We saw this one earlier. We'll see it again. Just, it's worth seeing two times. Kronovi's bump dribble thing.
I still just don't understand. I mean, the presence of mind to see him get that bump, and like, you know he saw the defenders. That's why he tried to beat them with the pop.
Yeah. Look at how fast he already
so
starts boosting.
Crazy.
Downwards, what? Just the recovery. Boop. Already on all fours. Boop. Back already gets another bump.
One, two, and three. I love commentating dribbles. It's like, oh, he gets one, he gets two, he gets three. Very rarely do you get to say the third one. It's usually just the two. But Darkfire, speaking of number two, here he is again. This guy, the give and go, putting it over to the side, gets the pass back, and then straight into the goal one more time. He's just the passing monster here.
His margin for error was so small on this shot. He just had to get there. He had no room. Look at where he squeezed it.
The timing on that flip is impeccable. I mean, he doesn't miss it by a second. If he was any later, I think he would have hit the post or he would have got bumped.
Number one, Garrett G, going back to NRG, the monster himself. We've seen him. We saw him do some of this in the.
Oh, no.
Yep.
Oh! Garrett G!
let's watch it again. Watch it again. Just rewind all the way. Yep, here we go.
He knows it's perfect, too. He knows
it. He knew it. He knew it immediately.
He boosted right away.
Oh, my gosh.
He didn't even care.
These guys.
These guys. You know?
It pisses me off so much. I practiced so much, and I could not ever do double touches even like half as good as Garrett G.
You're bad, and you should feel bad, Quinn.
Oh, should we talk about you?
I'm terrible, and I feel terrible every day for
okay.
it. Don't worry. I'm with you.
I just want to point out, we had a top five from a tournament that NRG won, and it didn't include a Jacob play. Like, technically, he scored the first goal, but he wasn't what made that first goal crazy.
Jacob
and Garrett G. It included two plays from NRG from two different players on NRG, and neither of them were Jacob. Tells you just how deadly NRG is right now.
All three of them, and to give him, even with a sub, Nose Dude has been playing out of his mind.
Yeah, seriously, ever since DreamHack Atlanta, that guy has been on another level.
How
like,
often
really
do you see,
so good.
How often do you see a mid-air targeted demolition on a defender? And I imagine being in Sad Junior, knowing him, because I've talked to him quite a bit, but the moment that happened, he's like, what? What? The moment you just don't exist and a goal goes in, especially because all he saw was explosion, and then he saw, douche. Garrett scored and Jacob? I think
Jacob
scored.
Douche,
Jacob scored. He's like, what?
Yeah,
it was such a good like approach as well, because Tad Jr. does not see Nose Dude coming at all.
No,
I mean, he's like seriously in the bottom of the screen and then just comes out of nowhere and just and Sad Jr.
Yeah, it is the perfect. You actually like, I think it was Sad Jr.'s car basically is in the way of seeing Nose Dude come at him, you know? Like, and it's just, like you said, perfect.
You just see like the little name tag slowly getting bigger pop out of nowhere.
Yeah,
if I had a small champagne problem, I would have almost loved that it wasn't a demolition, because watching people sail across the map is always just a little bit funnier.
Yeah.
Like, when you bump somebody, you're like, bye! And just gets sent to the moon.
And then
that
would have
been a little bit funnier, but it was still a great play.
Come on, Nose Dude, get it together.
Backwards.
We want bumps, not demos.
Nose Dude, can't you just figure it out?
Come on!
Go for bumps, because they're funnier. And I want to laugh. That's all I care about.
Oh, man.
Humor. to top get me five. Up in the morning.
Top five plays. Always so much fun here on Overtime. But that's going to do it for this episode. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a blast. Next week's going to be a lot of fun, too. The season is approaching. RLCS is just around the corner. We're going to have lots of great information next week. So stay tuned to this channel. Don't go anywhere. Stay right here for a whole week. It'll be a lot of fun. I'm kidding. Go do what you got to do. We'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
No, stay.
No, this is okay. They can stay.